Downtown Miami began really late, relatively speaking, 1896. So of the major cities in America, this is among the very youngest. For example, in 1895, the year before the railroad appeared in Miami, we had a wilderness with just 9 people living on both banks of the river at its mouth. That's how tiny it was. There was no downtown. This is where Miami as a city began in 1896. This is where Miami developed. This is where Miami evolved. The most important area in all of Miami-Dade County, I'd say up through the early post-World War II years and decades, was downtown Miami. Flagler Street downtown represented the center of entertainment up into the 60s, the center of retail up into the 60s, the center of the professional offices, meaning, you know, doctors and dentists and attorneys and what have you, into the 1960s. It was the great parade street for Miami. It's where the courthouse sits. And the court was one of the most important institutions in all of Miami. So virtually anything that was of importance in greater Miami, which is today an enormous county, was centered on Flagler Street for probably the first 60 years of Miami's history. It wasn't called Flagler Street until the fall of 1920. You had parades on Flagler Street. That was the chief parade street. You had a great park, Royal Palm Park, that backed up to Flagler Street. So visitors gathered oftentimes in the park for concerts and what have you. And Flagler Street was right in their back door, more or less. It has been the most important street in Miami for almost the entire existence of the city of Miami.
Flagler Street is serving as a catalyst for the future growth of downtown Miami. We wanted to make sure that we were highlighting the future of Flagler Street and what it could become. We're planning to have a socially distanced fashion show, so we partnered with Olympia Theater, our iconic historic theater, to make that happen. Galore Magazine, the Blondes, our local business partners, and our property owners all came into play to make that vision come alive.
Thank you.
IDA and our local partners at the City of Miami have been working really hard to bring new-to-market businesses, especially to downtown Miami. We want to create a vibrant downtown, and so bars and restaurants are becoming vibrant again. Through the pandemic, it was a challenge, but now they see the opportunity. Businesses such as Lost Boy, Over Under, Black Market, Nova Cove, we have restaurants here that are really getting highlighted because of the event that we did. And we really see that as the future of Flagler Street. This is a historic street. It has beautiful architecture from the 1900s till now. It is very special. We showcased an outdoor event on a historic street that a lot of people haven't been to in a long time.
You got a large residential population now. You didn't have in 72 or 82 or 92, but these big buildings that have gone up on the last couple of booms, the boom that started in 2002, the boom that started in 2012, have brought a lot of people downtown along Biscayne Boulevard, and Flagler Street is right there for all of this. The DDA can further activate Flagler Street through its musical offerings and different events. It will be a tremendous boost to downtown's fortunes.
The special guests that we had at the event were really exciting. We really wanted to focus on women in music, and so IvyQueen, the queen of reggaeton, was a showcase star at the event, including Mariah Angeliq, an up-and-coming local Miami star, and Vikina. We also had several athletes, several influencers at the event that made it very easy for the event to go viral, and we've gotten millions of views off this event. We also had our local politicians and our community partners. Our chairman, Manolo Reyes, was instrumental in making sure that the event came off without a hitch, including our district commissioner, Ken Russell, and our county commissioner, Eileen Higgins. After the event, we've received so many different inquiries about different industries that weren't necessarily the norm for Miami and downtown Miami. So it's really exciting to see the different partners that want to come to the table to do future activations. This event showcased to the world that downtown Miami is open for business, that Flagler Street is a place that can thrive for business. And this event really highlighted a safe event that brought everybody together, but also showcased Miami in a unique way. It was a small glimpse of what's to come on Flagler Street with the revitalization project. It's so exciting to showcase our historic Flagler Street in this way.